Welcome to our first instrumental recital. Now tonight's concert looks a little bit different to how I imagined it back in January. Before January, we didn't have that many instrument lessons happening at ASB. There were a couple which were happening after school, but we literally just didn't have the space to be able to teach. So for the last year and a half, these practice rooms have been planned and built. And then in January, we could start the instrument lessons based upon a new model for ASB, which is a concept of a pullout model, which means that students have the lessons in place of their curriculum lessons. Just over 30 students signed up. And most of these students who you're going to see were absolute new starters, which means that they haven't played instruments before. They started with no instrumental experience. We had a handful who'd already played instruments before, and it's been really nice to see how much progress that they've made in such a short amount of time. So in tonight's concert, you're going to meet these students. They're going to share their work with you, but you're also going to meet the teachers, and they're going to talk a little bit about what it's been like teaching in a virtual school, and also to introduce themselves so that you get to know them. I just want to say a couple of thank yous, and one of the thank yous is to the teachers. Obviously, starting a new position in a new program has been quite demanding, and then to change after a really short amount of time to virtual school, all the teachers have just done so well. They've been so encouraging, they've wanted to push the students, and they've really wanted to focus on giving the high quality lessons that we normally can offer within school. I also want to take a moment to thank the parents as well, because trusting in a new system and being able to sign up for something which they didn't know what it looked like has, you know, really helped us grow this instrumental lesson system. And during the next few years, we're going to see music just grow and grow and grow within the school. We're going to start with my two students. So I teach trumpets and I teach saxophone along other things, but I've just decided to have the two students. And I'm quite lucky really because my trumpet student, Cece, we had a little bit of an experience with online tuition last summer. So I really felt that I could help my team and help the instrumental teachers with the lessons and with the technology which is needed. My other student who you're going to see is Marcel. Now, Marcel's only been playing the saxophone since January, so I'm sure that you're going to be amazed with his progress. I really hope that you enjoy the show, and again, thank you for everybody who's taken part in it. It's really, really positive to see how much progress these kids have made in such a short time. Enjoy.
Thank you. Hi everyone. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Ivana and I've been a piano teacher at the American School of Barcelona since the end of January, meaning that I only got a chance to work like a month and a half with all the children before all this thing with Corona started. So we were supposed to carry and with the classes. And I must say I was very skeptical when it comes to online teaching, because I just thought that that would be impossible when it comes to piano. So I must say that I'm pleasantly surprised, first of all, that that is actually working, and that in some cases it's even easier because the student has their own instrument and I have my instrument, so it's kind of easier to have a dialogue between instruments, which when you work in just a classroom with one instrument is not possible. The second thing that was a true discovery for me is that students actually develop their listening skills, because when you work this way you just need to pay more attention to what the teacher is saying, because the connection sometimes is not good, the sound is not good, they're sitting too far away from the keyboard, so there are like millions of little distractions. And I'm pleasantly surprised that the children that are just 7, 8 years old were able to focus even more than during real piano lessons. And the thing that I really found very, very pleasant during this experience was that I got the chance to get to know the parents, and they got to know me. And it's like for this kind of activity, for playing an instrument, the support of parents is really, really important. And when it comes to their homework, when it comes to just reminding them that they need to practice a little bit, it would be impossible to do that without involvement of parents. So for me, it was a good chance to get to know to kids a little bit more and their parents as well. And finally, I really need to thank Kevin Hebden, who's the director of this entire program, for giving us absolute freedom to organize classes how we think it's the best. And he was really, really helpful in just calming the entire situation and slowly introducing how to do this online. The school provided some software, I don't know, which made things easier for when it comes to recording and just sending videos. So really, really a very nice experience. And it's good to know that in case of emergency, or when things are not the way we are used to doing them, to know that this way of teaching is also quite works quite well, and can be a very nice substitute for like a real human experience. So we prepared some of the songs, and I hope you will like that. And each kid got to learn around 3-4 pieces, but it's gonna be up to 2 now. So I hope you will enjoy that. And they really, really work hard, and I'm very happy for that. Okay, ciao. Thank you.
Jacques. Joy. Thank you. This is Fred Jacks. Bye-bye.
Hi, I'm gonna play the blue Danube. Yeah. That's it, and yeah, I hope you like it. So I'm gonna play Old MacDonald and the song with no name on. So I'm gonna start with Old MacDonald. Today I'm gonna do Do a Dare and The Wheels in the Bus and Ode to Joy. I'm gonna start. Yeah, I'm going to turn the pan on. Thank you. And now I'm going to do the wheels and the bus. Is Ode to Joy. So thank you, and that's all my songs, so goodbye.
Hello, my name is David and I'm the guitar, bass and ukulele teacher. I've been teaching in ASB since February. Teaching these virtual instrument lessons has been a challenge, but the outcome has been positive. The communication with the students is different, the approach is different. When you are in a face-to-face situation, it's easy to tell them the solution faster and easier. But in this scenario, they should think a little bit deeper and come out with their own solutions. In some cases, some students could concentrate more, and in general, they listen more attentively to what they are playing. Also, the involvement of the parents is a great benefit for the kids. I'd like to thank Mr. Kevin Hebden for his support and help and advice. Thank you, Kevin, for making things easier. And I'd like to congratulate the students for their hard work in preparing for this concert. And thank you for making us a little bit happier. I'm sure that we'll be a little bit happier after we listen to each one of you. Thank you very much.
Lucia and Lulu, and I'm going to be playing Music is Healing on the guitar.
I'm Miss Heidi. I've been working at ASB for the last 11 years. I've been teaching piano, after school piano, for the last 4 years. My degree, I studied in the Royal Conservatory of Toronto in Canada, and I got my degree for the Liceu de Barcelona. And I enjoy teaching piano very much.
Hi, my name is April, I'm in third grade, and I'm going to be playing El Canto del Cuco.
song Ode to Joy.
Hey everybody, this is Mr. Steven, drum teacher. I'm coming at you from my brand new home studio. Check it out. Okay, so it's my living room, but it actually is my new home studio for the past couple of months. And it's worked out really well. I gotta tell you, as a drum teacher, I've been doing this for a very long time and I've taught tens of thousands of drum lessons in my career. But when this whole thing started back in the middle of March, I had taught exactly zero online drum lessons. So this has obviously been a real learning experience for all of us. And hats off and a round of applause to all of you, the students, the parents, the administrators, all of us teachers, for being able to improvise and to accept a new challenge and move forward and find a way through. I do believe that as a musician, the ability to improvise and be creative is crucial, and this has definitely taught us to be a little bit better at that. So I think that everything that we've all learned together and all of the work that we've put in to these online lessons will absolutely help all of us, teachers and students in school, to do what we do a little bit better when the world comes back around, hopefully not too long from now. So. From the bottom of my heart, I say thank you to everybody who's participated in this project, and let's keep moving on. Rock on, drummers. Hey, Nick, how you doing?
Good.
Do you have a real drum set at home?
No.
Oh, boy, so how in the world are you ever going to be able to do your drum set lessons?
Drum set.
Ah, cool. That's the thing in front of you, isn't it? So why don't you show us the parts of your homemade drum set, and then maybe you can show us how you learned how to play something on it. Okay, so show us the different parts.
This is the snare drum.
Okay, looks like a Tupperware container. Yeah, what else?
This is the tom-tom.
I can't really see that, but I think that's a Nike box, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is the right cymbal.
And that's some sort of a metal thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, what else?
This is the floor tom.
A green plastic box,
this
isn't it?
This is a hi-hat.
That's the back of a chair. Perfect.
And this is the crash cymbal.
Lampshade. Now don't break that thing. Cool. So, oh, and what about your kick drum? What about your bass drum?
My bass drum is a box.
And what do you do with it? Just stomp on it, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me hear how that bass drum sounds. Cool. Hey, Nick, that's very creative and innovative of you to come up with a drum set at home out of everyday objects that you already had. Very, very well done, Nick. I'm gonna play Basic Rock 3, all right? Here we go. 1, 2, ready, go. Cool, right? All right. Great, now let's hear your Basic Rock 3 on your homemade drum set. Awesome job, Nick. So I have a question for you. How much did it cost you to buy all of these things for your homemade drum set? Nothing. That's what. That's it cost you nothing because you already had them at home. So it's great because you can use these invented homemade drums to make sure that you really like the instrument, and maybe, just maybe, if you work really hard, maybe, just maybe, one day you can get the real instrument for yourself at home. Let's keep it up, okay?
Two, ready, go.
Thank you. there, my name is Nicole Lewis and I teach piano and violin and trumpet at the ASB. It was a bit sad because we had just gotten started with lessons really at the end of January, and then the lockdown and quarantine happened, and I've never actually taught students online before, so I wasn't quite sure how it would go or if I would even be any good at it. But it's been a really nice experience actually for me. The students have really risen to the occasion, and you know, they've progressed and they've done well, and it's been nice to stay connected to them during this time. And you know, there were times, you know, the lockdown has been difficult for everyone, I think, and there were times when I just woke up feeling, you know, down or a bit sad about it, but you know, you have a lesson and you know, the kids are still bright and happy and making you smile, and it really helped me get through it all. So I'm really proud of all of them and all of that they've done in this concert. So really well done, guys.
Thank you. You know I want you. It's not a secret I try to hide. I know you want me. So don't keep saying our hands are tied. You play with not in the cards, face pulling you miles away and out of reach from me. But you're here in my heart, so stop me if I decide that you're my destiny. What if we like the stars? Say you were made to be mine. Nothing could keep us apart. If you were what I was meant to find. It's up to you, and it's up to you. No one can say what we get to be. So why don't you leave like stars? Baby, go out to the eyes tonight. You think it's easy? You think I don't wanna run to you? But you're a man. Wondering what because we're able to be just you and me within these walls. But when we go outside, we can wake up and see that it was hopeless after all. No one can hear like the stars. How can you say you're behind? Everything keeps us apart. And I'm not the one you were meant to find. It's not up to you, it's not up to me. When everyone tells us what we can be, how can we rewrite the stars? Say that the world can be ours. Tonight all I want is to fly with you. All I want is to fall with you. So just is it impossible? Say that it's possible. How do you leave like a star? Say you were made to be mine. Nothing can keep us apart. But you are the one I was meant to find. It's up to you and it's up to me. No one can say what we get to be. And why don't we rewrite the stars, taking the world to the eyes? You know I want you. It's not a secret I try to hide, but I can't have you. About to break and my hands are tied.
Thank you. collect things like ashtrays and art. Betcha they're good. Why shouldn't they be? Their one mistake was giving up me. So maybe now it's time. And maybe when I wake, they'll be there calling me. Betcha he reads, betcha she sews. Maybe she's made me a closet of clothes. Maybe they're strict, as straight as a line. Don't really care as long as they're mine. Me now this pair's the last one of it. Won't you please come get your baby? Maybe.
Mm-hmm.